Did you know that you can use Figma sections to simplify your prototypes to become faster and use less frames? If you are using Figma sections only to organize your files, you are not using it to its full potential. They are great to visually group frames on the canvas, but you can do a lot more. In this video, I will show you how you can improve your prototypes in just a few steps. It will help you so much. So, the basic idea, as you already know, is that you can put your frames and other items into sections like this. And that's it. This is already very handy, but we can do more with sections. What happens when you need to prototype a scenario like this, where you navigate between pages, return to the home page, and then select again, wanting to continue where you left off. But it starts all over again. So now, imagine scaling this to a more complex prototype. You need to duplicate infinite times the same screen and drag the connections. It's so time-consuming. Now, in prototyping, sections help Figma remember the last image viewed in a section. So, when you return, it displays that image first. Cool, right? So, right now, if you don't use sections to simplify your prototypes, you are having a lot of work. Let's see how you can do it. To create a section, press Shift-S and drag around the frames that should be in the same category. In this example, these could include frames for mountains, waterfalls, and even the home page. After you link your frames, showing the natural next and previous photo, you need to link from the mountains card in the home page to the mountains section where you contain each frame, and then you can do the same for waterfalls. Just like that. Now, when you play the prototype and select mountains, then we go to the next one. If you now click the home icon to view the menu again and select mountains, it will remember where you were before. So this is so useful, and if you do the same for waterfalls, you'll experience the same behavior. So now, if I click in waterfalls and go to the next one, then go back to the home icon and click back again to the waterfalls, see that it will remember where I was before. So go try for yourself, you'll drastically reduce the number of frames in your work. Let me know in the comments if this helps you. And that's it. I hope this can improve the way you prototype using Figma sections. Like and subscribe the video so that it will help this video reach out other designers that could find this valuable. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Have a great day.